A nebulous nightmare. An apocalypse that only we can oppose. To recall a thing is to make it real once more. A drop of sanity in a sea of madness. Leper. A little more light, a little more strength. The road calls once more to its dark passenger. You must face your failures, or be consumed by them. Time and time again, I impressed upon you that any adulation afforded us would be fleeting if we could not properly defend our findings. The crossroads, a beacon for the broken and the battered. Pride, more devastating than the horrors of 100 campaigns. Indiscriminate science stains the surgeon's hands. Avarice slips unseen into the catacombs of the mind. Thank you. This was a beautiful place once. What a pity. Harshly on the far side of the brook. You see, even your valley is not immune to the spreading stain. In crisis, we can rely only upon each other. Measure out your violence and apply it judiciously. Cooperation is the key. Measured and steady. Strength dwindles. Righteous action. sweet reprieve until the next test is put before you. Yet places such as this, where a little light still gathers. Learn what can be taught, that you may stand just a little taller at the end. Shall we continue, or is the lesson too demanding? Anything that lets us travel further is worth the cost. Trinkets and baubles, paid for in blood. Your coach must be maintained if it is to carry you where you must go. Every road a winding torment. Every turn bent on our destruction. Resignation. The unknown awaits. Be wary. Sharpen your blades, that we may properly excise our portion. Thank you. Cooperation is the key. Crisis. We can rely only upon each other. On to the next. A miscalculation, perhaps. Hold fast, for who knows what lurks in the beyond. Victory supposes strategy. Press on. Collaboration confers advantage. A masterstroke. Cooperation is the key. Sweat-soaked brows, unsteady stances. Exhaustion takes hold. Malaise, measured and steady. Righteous action. Mm-hmm. crisis, we can rely only upon each other. Steady yourself. Fight through the fatigue. Who will face the half-remembered horrors of their past? Chapter 5. Behold the Man. Once more he wandered, ravenous for fresh suffering and delighting in its novelty and excess. Offering himself to Blade and Talon alike, he became an icon writ in flesh, a living prayer to whatever gods would turn an ear. Undying, he savored his delicious declension, an eternity of pain and wrath, heaven on earth. Coach's plating is spent. We are exposed. Look upon their noble struggle and be humbled by it. Is your coach prepared for the upcoming obstruction? Look ahead. A place to reflect, remember, and reconcile. Chapter 2, Head of the Class. The professor was a relic, hacking and wheezing his way through a hopelessly conventional curriculum. Only when we acknowledge the past can we be free from it. Our protection has been stripped to its last. The enemy weakens and wanes. In crisis, we can rely only upon each other. Cunning. You may outwit them yet. Empowered, emboldened. Deliberate and methodical appliance of harm. Malaise, measured and steady. Cooperation is the key. Variable can make all the difference. An unexpected find.
The loathing whispers.
Mind your wheels. They have nothing left to give. Miscalculation, perhaps. Suffering begins. Cooperation is the key. In crisis, we can rely only upon each other. Cannot be walked alone. Collaboration confers advantage. Calculated generosity, but a welcome one nonetheless. Measured and steady. Well done. Cooperation is the key. Bravo! In crisis, we can rely only upon each other. Agony by accumulation. An interminable conflict. Deliberate and methodical appliance of harm. The loathing abates. The place is a little worse for wear, but familiar nonetheless. Spend what you can, or wealth no longer has meaning, if indeed it ever did. Learn what can be taught, that you may stand just a little taller at the end. Each improvement, a new variable in the equation of your fate. Every league, a lesson. Something to ease the rigors of the road. Provinces and cantrebs of our land, crumbling and undone. The barnacled timbers of the coastal villages are sodden with salt and secrets. Propriety floats listless on the tide, brined in noxious degradation.
The loathing whispers. We must keep moving. This is no place for decent folk. The loathing festers. In crisis, no gain is insignificant. Your collection can wait. Press onward. The loathing howls. Chapter 2. Nightcap. Night after night of disrespect and abuse, enough was enough. She listened, smirking, as his empty apologies came in desperate, choking gags.
Echoes of humanity, twisted by hopelessness. Agony by accumulation. Abandoned or forgotten, it is ours now. Chapter 3, Embarrassment of Riches. years of decadence and financial mismanagement had left the estate in staggering debt. Humiliated and facing eviction, she wandered the empty halls, hurling inebriated indignities at the portrait of the deceased, whose hand had rested so possessively upon her shoulder. A gleam of gold on that painted paw reminded her that his rings were unaccounted for, and must have been buried with him. Repair the damage and be off. Accumulation. Stumbling and stupefied. And vexation. Collaboration confers advantage. Thank you.
Little help impeccably timed. Masterstroke. Thank you. us hope these repairs will hold. Fiend's strength dwindles. Empowered, emboldened. The enemy weakens and wanes. Hold fast, for who knows what lurks in the beyond. Collaboration confers advantage. Cooperation is the key. Foundation of trust. Darkness encroaches, inexorable.
crisis, we can rely only upon each other. Self-reliance is a rare and wonderful thing. Steady yourself. Last, the thing is finally passed on. The fiend's strength dwindles. Sweat-soaked brows, unsteady stances. Exhaustion takes hold. And now, the greatest test of all. The sum total of violent equation, unfavorably rounded down. An interminable conflict. A slow dissection. An unavoidable end. In life or in death, we are all prisoners here. Save themselves, they would slip beneath the brackish waters and be reborn in the image of their aquatic demiurge. Up ahead, the seat of our regrettable research. Self-reliance is a rare and wonderful thing. Unpleasant in the extreme. This work is noble and necessary. Protection has been stripped to its last. We must preserve what is best in us. The loathing whispers.
The loathing festers. Slow suffering begins. Excellent work. Agony by accumulation. Sacrifice bestows an uncertain absolution. What is it, then, that gazes back so intently from the abyss? There remains a foothold out of this mire. Now climb. once again, teetering on that terrible precipice. Death comes for the rich and poor alike. On and on, over and over, until the truth is laid bare, and you are finally free.